Video Kick Clubbers, it's Demo Donna here with Sparkle and Sprinkle, and this month we are going to be doing this awesome card, and I'm going to be showing you a couple different embossing techniques, as well as using our digital stamps with the rubber stamp, and we're going to be using a really beautiful sugaring technique where I take one of our glitters with our brushable glue. The stamp set we're going to be using is the Country Flower. And this is so pretty, and there are three different fun sayings that you can use to put inside of your card with one of the embossing powders chosen. And this is by Jan Mayhew. I hope you love it. It's nice and simple, yet very stunning, perfect for a summer card. So I'm going to start by taking my embossing ink, and I'm just going to go around the edge of my digital printout. Now, in your video kit, you are going to get 5 of these pre-printed out. If you want to go ahead and order the digital stamp along with, so you can recreate with that, you can do that. And then you are going to be receiving the actual rubber stamp set in the kit as well. So I've gone around my whole edging with my embossing ink. You can also use your VersaMark. And then I'm going to take my chartreuse embossing powder. So we are just creating a really cool vintage look, but using a colored embossing powder. So we're going to be tying in the background color of our background paper with the really cool edging of our chartreuse embossing powder. And this is one of our cosmic embossing powders. I like to use our cosmics more in a mixed media fashion like this one. So now I'm going to heat set all around the edges. And I'm just going to do one layer in the video, but for my sample card, I went over it again and did 2 layers, and that's what got the really dark finish around the edges. So finish heating that up entirely. And if you get some of your embossing powder on your design and you don't want to do it, just brush it off. You can use a dry brush or your finger tool. So I'm going to finish this up. There we go. And like I said on my sample card here, I did 2 layers. So you could see the difference between the 1 layer, which is done here, and the 2 layers. So it's nice and dark. Okay, so next we are going to take our brushable glue. You're going to get a little sample bottle in your video kit club, but I'm going to use the larger bottle that I have with me. And I'm just going to dip my brush into my brushable glue, and I'm going to apply a nice amount and go around my flower. I am actually going over all of the shadowing. Your brushable glue is going to dry nice and clear. So you're going to still see the detail of your stamp design. And it dries pretty quickly, so I wouldn't try to do too much because you can continue to go around it. And I am using Diamond Dust, which is one of our chunkier glitters. Really pretty. I absolutely love it. So I'm going to take my Diamond Dust, tap that off, and then I'm going to go and do another section. So you could see here, I'm just going over the shadowing with my fine detail brush. Okay, so I went ahead and just made sure all of my shadowing was complete. And I finished putting the second layer of the embossing powder around the edges. So I did a second layer and heat set it. All right, and I am just gonna make sure that all of my little shadowing is covered with the Diamond Dust. It's so pretty and it's such a sparkly glitter that I really want to make sure I get all that beautiful color everywhere. All right, so next I'm going to set this aside and we are going to work on our background. So I'm going to take my sticker paper, and this is 4 inches by 5 1/4. And this is just going to be the background here, so you don't have to completely cover the entire section of it with your embossing powder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my chartreuse, and I'm just going to go ahead and make sure I'm at least getting like 1/2 inch coverage. And this is such a really fun technique. You can create all sorts of different looks. And it's a really great finish. It looks like more of a leathery finish. Really pretty, really shiny. And just think of all the different possibilities. I'm going to be using chartreuse and antiquities. But if you did this with a black embossing powder or another different color, I am going to go ahead and heat set this. So I've already got one completed. And once you have fully heat set your chartreuse, what you're going to do next is take your rubber stamp from your stamp set. And you can either use your embossing ink, or I'm going to use my VersaMark pad. And I'm just going to go over all the corners. So I'm going to do that one. And I am just making sure I am stamping over all of my chartreuse. And don't worry, if you miss a section, you can just go over it after you've already heat set. So I've got one corner left. And now I'm going to sprinkle on Antiquities, which is a really beautiful embossing powder. It's also a cosmic embossing powder. And it has a really beautiful, very like a metallic-y look to it. So I'm going to go all around, give that a good tap, and you can see you've already got that pattern of the flowers coming in the background. And it's just going to be a very subtle background once we heat set this. Because the two embossing powders are from the same family, they're going to really melt together beautifully. So I'm going to give that a little heat so you can see how pretty they look when they melt together. So see how gorgeous that is? You can right away see how beautiful those colors go together. And remember how I said you can blend different colors? Here's just a little sample of what it looks like to make it with a white background, which is really, not the white background, but to stamp it and use. I used one of our detail white embossing powders. So you have a lot of different possibilities. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my two different layers here. Pardon my reach. And I'm going to take my card base. And I've got some terrific tape on the back of our sticker paper. So I'm going to peel that off. I've got four pieces on there. And it's such a beautiful texture. I can't wait till you guys try this and actually feel what your paper feels like. It is very cool. So I'm going to lay that down. Got a really cool background. And then I added some of my dimensional adhesive to the back. You can use the clear that we used a couple in last month's, or you can use some of your foam tape. And I am just going to wrap that around. Oh, look, it's too short. Ha ha. Okay, we're going to wrap that around twice, but not really because mine's too short, but we're not filming this again because that would be just ridiculous. So we're going to wrap it around once. My sample's twice, but I know you guys love that I make mistakes, right? Wink, wink, nod, 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 nod. Okay, I'm going to trim my edges there. And my beautiful sample here, I wrap two around. And you will get enough to have 2 feet for each card, so you'll have plenty of space. It's all about the preparation, Demo Donna. All right, I'm going to peel my backing off. Of all those guys. All right, and then we are just going to lay that down there. And voila, we'll show you our one with the right amount of tying. And like I said, you can take your antiquities, ooh, I think we should do that now, and go ahead and pick out a seine and stamp that in the middle. So I'm going to use this one that says, "Little moments with you matter a whole bunch to me." I'm doing a lot of traveling this summer, and this is going to be a really great card to have on hand to leave as a thank you for being, you know, for hanging out with different friends. It's also going to be a great way to, I can throw a happy birthday in there. I'm going to use my little static free bag and add my VersaMark, stamp that down, add my Antiquities. Such a beautiful embossing powder. I know you guys are going to love it. Tap that off. Heat set. Love it. So pretty. Oh, I missed a spot. And then you can even take your paintbrush and add a little bit more of that beautiful diamond dust. And I am just going to do a big brush stroke underneath it, which I think will make it look pretty cool. Sprinkle that on. Tap that off. And voila, you've got a great little seine inside. And like I said, there are three different seines to choose from on this stamp set. And this was a really fun example to show you guys the difference between the digital stamp versus the rubber stamp and the different things that you can do with both.